You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk about conversational AI tooling. You can get up and running all from the command line locally or in the cloud. Justin and Carlos are going to show us how. Make sure you watch this episode. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're going to talk all about conversational AI tooling. I have two guests. Why don't you introduce yourselves? Tell us who you are and what you do. We'll start with you, Carlos.
Yeah. Hello, I'm Carlos Castro. I'm an engineer at Fuse Labs within Microsoft AI and Research.
Fantastic.
Yeah. I'm Justin Willoughby. I am also an engineer and developer at Microsoft Fuse Labs and AI Research.
Awesome. So let's get started. What are we talking about today?
Today we're talking about tooling for conversational AI.
Okay.
So yeah, one would wonder, why do we want tooling around conversational AI, right? And the reason is that we want to empower developers to infuse AI into their applications, right? And we want to do that through a rich tool ecosystem that allows them to span the end-to-end development workflow and at the same time do it in any platform and do it in an open source way.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So is this for building actual bots, or is it just, is it for something more general than that?
Yeah, this is going to be for the entire workflow. So as a developer approaches the build of a bot, the construction of a bot, there's various services that they're going to need to build and construct.
Sure.
This tooling helps the developer through each stage of that workflow to accomplish what they're trying to accomplish faster.
I see. And so it's just like tooling for me to get up and running. So can you explain to me a little bit like what the process is, so I can get a sense for like how this goes?
Yeah, for instance, one of the first steps in building out a bot might be the planning stage. Mm-hmm. And during the planning stage, there's going to be presentations that you'll have to make for business and for the stakeholders mm-hmm. to pitch your idea. Part of that is modeling conversations. So we have tools that enable that. You might want to model a very simple conversation that would involve a greeting, or a more complex workflow, mm-hmm. which would involve, for instance, booking a hotel or booking a table at a cafe. Mm-hmm. So the idea is that you generate a conversation from a markdown file,
okay.
and then use our chatdown tool to take that markdown file and convert it into a transcript. That transcript then is going to have the conversation between the bot and the person. From that transcript, you can import it into the emulator and play it back. And it would display exactly how the conversation might look to the user communicating with that bot.
I see.
You can present that to your stakeholders, present that to business to really help them internalize the idea and that
so
concept.
Instead of like coming with some really crazy workflow, is this an example of what a conversation might look like? You upload it and then it does its magic to do its thing.
Yeah, in a sense, yep.
All right, do you have something you can show us?
Yeah, and it's quite amazing that instead of like building the bot before getting buy-off from your management, you can create this transcript file with our tools, and suddenly you can playback the conversation, for example, in this case, for booking a table, without actually building the bot. But you could show your management how the experience is going to be, and then show how people will book a table. And then your management will accept it or request changes, and then you can go to the next stage, which is to actually build your bot.
Oh, I see. So this is more of like a modeling tool of what your conversation could look like, and everyone's like, yep, looks great, move on, or no, you know, they're probably going to ask this or do that. You should model that in there
exactly.
as well.
And the nice thing about it is it makes it easy to go over multiple scenarios, to really understand what different scenarios would look like to the user.
I see. Yeah. So, for this, is this just a markdown file that I upload somewhere?
Yeah, so this is a markdown file that you would author by hand.
Okay.
This markdown file then becomes the input to the chatdown CLI. So we can show an example of how this might be used in the command line.
Let's do it.
So you open up the command line, type chat down. There's various options that are available to you for use within this tool. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be taking our markdown file as the chat down input.
Okay.
And that file is going to then output a transcript. And this transcript is simply an array of activities that we can then use to import into the emulator. So once we've created a transcript, we import it into the emulator, and we can see that it plays back those activities within that transcript.
I see. So this is just a way to visualize an entire conversation with exactly how it would look like in the chatbot.
Yeah.
This isn't really creating anything other than for the stakeholders, you're able to see the flow
exactly.
and get buy-off immediately.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. But at this point, you get buy-off from your management. You're ready to build your bot.
Right. Yeah, right? Because you've got something
yeah.
tangible. Yeah.
And what's the first step to build a bot? A bot is a service that will understand natural language. Mm-hmm. So we need to build and infuse natural language understanding into that bot.
Right, and so usually what I would do is I would do something with the bot framework and set something up. Is this, you're telling me there's something you can do in the CLI to help do this?
Yeah.
Cool.
So we're going to run through this entire process in CLI.
Oh, okay. Yeah. This is kind of cool. Like, yeah. We're going to make the whole thing from soup to nuts directly. Okay, let's see it.
Yeah. So the first step to understand language is to generate a LUIS model. LUIS is, at Microsoft, we have our Language Understanding Intelligence Service. So LUIS allows you to create a model and define intents, which are user intentions. For example, greet, say hi, right? And for each intent, define utterances, which are ways in you could show that intention, right? So here I have an example of another Markdown file. We really like Markdown, so we're extending it to the maximum possible extent. So here is an example of a greeting. So to show the greeting intent, I have two examples, which are hello and hi.
I see.
And this is a very simple way to create something really complex, which is a very complex machine learning model that will understand human language for us.
Oh, I think I'm starting to understand, because traditionally, I would go into LUIS, I would type in all the things, I would mark up the thing, and then I would train it. You're saying now with this, you can just define them in files that we're all comfortable with, and then push it up at our convenience later.
Exactly. Yes. And not only that, from this command line, so we have our Markdown, right? Mm-hmm. From this Markdown, we can generate a LUIS model using the LUDown command line tool. Mm-hmm. And once we have the LUIS model, we can further actually import this into LUIS. So this command will actually be the same as going to the portal and creating all the intents and everything, just in one line. And actually, there is another thing called MSBot here, where I'm piping the output of importing the model. And do you know what that is?
Sure, yeah. You know, the emulator really is central to the workflow within a developer when going through the bot building process. It enables various functionality that will allow the developer to move through the progression of concept to actually communicating with a LUIS model. The MSBot command line tool allows you to do a couple of things. One of them is create a bot file, which then becomes the project file you use in your emulator.
Okay.
It also allows you to connect services like the LUIS service to that bot file so that you can then import that into your emulator and see that service in action.
So let me see if I understand this correctly. The MSBot is the bot emulator, or is it more than that?
It's more than that. So the bot file is your project file, and that's going to define services that are available to the emulator to go out and retrieve intents from the LUIS model that you just uploaded, that you just trained.
I see. So there's a bot project. We just gave LUIS some ideas on how it needs to do the greetings, for example.
Yeah.
And then what we're doing is we're importing those files into LUIS, outputting them into the MSBot application, which is then going to let us see how that actually interacts.
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah.
Got it. Okay, cool. But
one way I like to think about it, about the bot file, is about the solution file in Visual Studio. Mm-hmm. Your project is around the Visual Studio solution, right?
I see.
In our case, your bot is around the bot file.
So does the bot file include other services like LUIS and other things? Oh, okay.
And that's,
that makes sense now.
Yeah, the MSBot allows us to link connected services to our bot. Think about Q&A Maker, mm-hmm. LUIS, other cognitive services.
Right.
In this case, we're showing LUIS as an example.
Okay,
but
cool.
It's an extensible model, right?
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Cool. So what happens when you run that MSBot LUIS import application command line?
So not only I imported LUIS, but I also connected my bot to LUIS. And when I go to emulator, we can see what happens.
Cool. And so there's the bot, right?
So here I have my cafebot.bot file that was generated from connecting the bot to LUIS, and I can open it in the emulator. And here it is. And I can say hello to my bot.
Oh, I see. So what's going on here, and now I'm like I'm slow, so I'm glad you're here to help me. So what you're doing is that MSBot generating that bot file and the entire project so that you can run this in the emulator with the connected services in the background.
Exactly.
Yeah, it provides a really easy way for the developer to create their project file, to import services to it, and then very quickly open it up in the emulator and see the result of those services that they've added.
I see. What other command line tools do you have? I mean, it feels like you're rounding out everything here.
Yeah, and this is a very exciting moment, right? Because we have our bot, we built it, right? And one other thing we would want to do maybe is to deploy it.
Right.
We want to publish it to Azure, right?
Sure.
We want to get it in Azure. And so for that, we have a tool called AZ, which is the Azure command line tool. It's nothing new, but now we have the new bot option, which allows us to perform a lot of operations on bots. We could create and update bots, but also we can publish our code to a bot. We can link a bot to GitHub.
This is cool because now I'm envisioning scenarios of like DevOps scenarios where we're able to pull in new bot information, create new bots on the fly, take down bots, et cetera.
Yeah,
cool.
Exactly. And another new feature that was very much requested, and we're very happy to announce it now, is that we are supporting managing channels through command line. That means that you can create a bot only once, you publish it only once, but then with a simple command, you can enable your bot, let's say, in Microsoft Teams, or in Skype, or in Facebook, right?
That's cool. That's cool. Yeah. I think one of the hard things is that each one of these services has their own API, and whatever the power of the bot framework is, it allows you to connect to any of them.
Exactly.
Cool.
So if I may show just one command.
Absolutely. Let's do it.
Let's say I have my bot, and I want to enable it for Microsoft Teams.
Okay.
Right. So what I will do, I will write az bot create, MS Teams create. And then I just need to pass my bot name. I have one bot that I already created. So I pass dash n and my bot name. And only with this command, I will be able to later go to a portal and talk, check it that actually my bot can talk through Teams, or people can simply add it in Microsoft Teams and talk to it.
That's cool.
Yeah, and actually I would like to show that.
Okay, let's look at it.
Because here's my bot in the Azure portal. And we can see that in the channels, we have Microsoft Teams now.
Uh-huh.
We can open it in Teams. And let's say hi to the Mr. Cafe bot.
So how was it able to connect to your Teams account? I mean, usually you have to like put some kind of key or do some kind of login. How does it know to link to the right one?
So a bot, one of the core pieces of a bot is the Microsoft App ID.
Uh-huh.
The Microsoft App ID is tied to every bot. And that connects us to all the Microsoft services. That's why it's so seamless to enable a bot for Skype, for Teams, for all the services we provide.
I see, because it knows who the owner of that service is.
Exactly.
So it knows what other services are attached that you can actually link to. Cool.
Yes.
Cool. Awesome. Well, what else do you have to show me?
That's pretty much it.
Yeah, that's about it. This tool chain is designed for the developer to help them through every step of their workflow when creating a bot, designing it, all the way through to getting into the emulator and something that they can actually test and hammer on and use.
The thing I like about this, and I mean, I can't stress this enough, is I'm always afraid to like create some new service and play with it there. This is actually letting me run it on my machine with my own files to get a feeling for what it looks like before I can push it up really easily.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. That's one of the great features that you have. You can start locally, then go to a cloud, or you could start in the cloud and then bring it locally, or start in the cloud and make it to GitHub and suddenly have continuous integration in a whole team working on a bot.
I see. And so the Lua stuff that you showed, does it have like Markdown for other types of services that you can add for like Q&A Maker, or is it just that service that has it?
Yeah, so the MSBot CLI would allow you to add services like Q&A Maker, Lewis, Dispatch, and some others that are connected services. Mm-hmm. It creates that project file and allows you to view those in the emulator itself.
And the other question I had is I saw, did it actually create like the actual bot code for you as well?
Yeah, so when you create a new bot through the Azure command line, you get an echo bot created for you, and you can start from there. Or you can actually enlist in our open source bot framework samples repo, and then you can clone any of those samples and publish it using the AZ bot publish. So you never go out of the command line to create a bot.
Which is super cool.
Yeah.
And now, is it Java? Is it the Node.js version or the C# version? Which one do you get to pick?
Whichever you like.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This is awesome. Well, I love this. I'm all about command line for making things a little bit easier. We've been learning all about this today. If you haven't done anything with chatbots, I think now is the time to literally start right now because we have some awesome tools.
Yep.
So thanks so much for spending some time with us.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for watching. We're learning all about how to create chatbots using the command line. My name is Seth Juarez. This is the AI Show. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.